When it comes to situation, let's say it's a financial, someone's taking your money, right? Mm-hmm. So the end, if there is going to be anti-charges, that person actually eventually does have to deal with police. Mm-hmm. There is no elder abuse criminal code offense, right? We don't have that. What we have is our criminal code offense. So if it's theft, it doesn't have an age. Mm-hmm. So theft of power of attorney, there is a criminal code offense for that. So if someone is taking your money under the under managing your finances or property as the attorney, and they're using it to go on trips to Vegas or wherever, and you left with nothing, and that is a, you know, if there's evidence enough to prove that, then they can be charged for theft of power of attorney. If you've given your, but if you've living with somebody and you've willingly given your debit card and you don't want anybody charged, it's up to you to make that charge, if I'm correct. So they're only in criminal, if the person does go to court, the judge does, there was a, I can't remember the actual section of the court, I just did this in my class last week. They're under the criminal code, the judge has jurisdiction to aggravating offenses for an older person or someone who's vulnerable. If there's a conviction, they can increase sentencing based on age or vulnerability and those circumstances. But there's no specific law for elder abuse. So we do education for commercials. We have done some in the past. There was a financial, emotional, and a physical one that was put on TV on a while back. There was the health, we didn't show it, but health, the federal government initiated a commercial in 2009. And that started, that was the first federal commercial we actually had around elder abuse. And it kind of was a, someone working through the window and snapshot of a grandson taking money out. That was on air for many years and resonated with a lot of people. Unfortunately, public service announcements cost thousands and thousands of dollars to air, to do the production, etc. So we try to do these kind of educational sessions to get the word out as well, to inform people about that.
You know, when things start changing, or even neighbors, keep notes of what's going on. So on this date, this is what was said, or this is what happened. So that, God forbid, anything happened, but you have a story to share. And all those notes and all that writing, and not that we don't believe you when you tell us, because it's in your head and you know it, but when you make notes and keep track, almost like a diary and a log, then that's good information that helps us be able to put that story together and put a case together, and that whole investigation part of telling in that. So the proof, it is difficult. It is. And it's like, because it's subtle, it's like, again, like anything, you know, I'm not abusing my mom. She's just getting old. She's forgetting things. Okay, well, we're not blind. We see things, and we do come in after the fact, but that's why we do our best to, you know, and when I do the education to the workers and nurses and PSWs at hospitals and in long-term care and retirement homes, keep note of all this. So God forbid anything happened, we come to you and say, well, what's going on? Well, every time, you know, Lisa comes in to see her mom behavior changes. She shuts down. And all this is contributing to the whole story of elder abuse, of financial abuse, or whatever it is.